Hi students, today we have to study the problem set 6 in which the first question is choose the correct alternative for each of the following. We have multiple choice questions here and we have to choose the appropriate answer, appropriate option for each and every example. Here the first example, sine theta into cosec theta is equal to question mark. We have to write the value of sine theta into cosec theta. As we know that sine and cosec, both the ratios are multiplicative inverse of each other since their product is 1. Sine and cosec, both are the multiplicative inverse of each other since their product is 1. So, the answer is option A, 1. Now, we have second question, that is cosec 45 is equal to question mark. We have to find the value of cosec 45. We have given the four options and you have to write the appropriate value of cosec 45. And the value of cosec 45 is root 2. If you have any problem to know the value of cosec 45, you can easily get the value of cosec 45. Just here we studied that cosec is multiplicative inverse of sine, and if you know the value of sine 45, then multiplicative inverse of sine 45 is cosec 45. We know that the value of sine 45 is 1 upon root 2, and reciprocal of 1 upon root 2 is root 2, that is cosec 45. So the correct answer is option B, square root of 2, that is the value of cosec 45. Or you can easily prepare a table and you will get the value of cosec 45. Third example, we have an identity, that is 1 plus tan square theta is equal to question mark, and that is 1 plus tan square theta is equal to sec square theta. So the correct answer is option C, sec square theta. And the last example, that is example number 4 from the first question, when we see at a higher level from the horizontal line, angle formed is, if we see above the horizontal line, we know that the angle formed is angle of elevation. And suppose if we see at the lower level of the horizontal line, then the angle formed is angle of depression. But since here we have to write, when we see at a higher level from the horizontal line, angle formed is angle of elevation. So correct answer is option A, angle of elevation. Second question from the problem set 6. The question is, if sine theta is equal to 11 upon 61, then find the value of cos theta using trigonometric identity. We have given the value of sine theta, that is 11 upon 61, and we have to get the value of cos theta using trigonometric identity. That is very important. Here we have two options. We can use triangle method. You can use the triangle method which we studied in the 9th standard, and here we studied in the 10th standard how to use the identities to get the remaining values of trigonometric ratios if you have given the any one ratio. So here we have given that sin theta is equal to 11 upon 61, and using the trigonometric ratio, using the trigonometric identity, we have to find the value of cos theta. Here we have to find the cos theta. It is given that sin theta is equal to 11 upon 61, and we have to get the value of cos theta. Now here we have to get an identity relating with these two trigonometric ratios, and that is sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. The identity which is related with these two ratios, sin and cos, it is sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So here we can write that identity, sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. It is an identity. And now here we have to put the value which we know, and we have to get the value of cos theta. So sin theta, value of sin theta is 11 upon 61. we have to make the square of it, plus cos square theta as it is, it is equal to 1. Now we have to simplify this trigonometric expression and we have to get the value of cos theta. See, the square of 11 is 121 upon square of 61, that is 3761. Square of 61 is 3761 plus is cos square theta as it is equals to 1. Now we have to find the value of cos theta. We have cos square theta here, but we have to get the value of cos theta. So we will put this cos square theta as it is and we will transfer this fraction 121 upon 3761 to the right side and we will get cos square theta is equal to 1 minus 121 upon 3761. And now we have to take the subtraction of these two numbers and the subtraction is cos square theta is equal to multiplication of denominators to the denominators, that is 3761, and cross multiplication is to the numerator, 3761 into 1 is 3761 minus 121 into 1 is 121. The subtraction is cos square theta is equal to 3600 divided by 3761. Now taking square root of both the sides, we will get the value of cos theta and we have cos theta is equal to 60 upon 61. Square root of 3600 is 60 and square root of 3761 is 61. So this is all about the second example. It is too easy, it is very easy. We have one more method, that is triangle method, but we are unable to use that method here because already in the question it is given that if sin theta is equal to 11 upon 61, then find the value of cos theta using trigonometric identity. And if nothing is given there in the question, then you can use one of the two methods, either triangle method or the identity method. So this is all about the second question. We will take the next question, that is third question. Third question from the problem set 6. The question is, if tan theta is equal to 2, then find the values of other trigonometric ratios. If tan theta is equal to 2, then find the values of remaining all the trigonometric ratios. We have given the value of tan theta. And this is tan theta is equal to 2, that is the given information. And here we have to get all the remaining trigonometric ratios, that is sin theta, cos theta, cot theta, sec theta and cosec theta. We have to get the remaining 5 trigonometric ratios. So here tan theta is equal to 2. So we have the identity that sec square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta, and using that identity we can get the value of sec theta. First you can get the value of cot theta also, any values we can get. See, tan theta is equal to 2, so you can write cot theta is equal to 1 upon 2, since the cot theta is the multiplicative inverse of the cot theta. Cot theta is the multiplicative inverse of the tan theta, since we have cot theta is equal to 1 by 2. But here we will first get the value of sec theta. If once you get sec theta, then cos theta is multiplicative inverse of sec theta. If you get the cos theta, then you can write sin theta using sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. And then you can get cosec theta, that is reciprocal of sin theta. So here we will use identities. So first of all we will write the identity sec square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. It is an identity. Put the values there. Sec square theta is equal to 1 plus 2 square. This is sec square theta is equal to 1 plus 4, that is 5. And taking square root of both the sides, we will get sec theta is equal to square root of 5. Now you can easily write the value of cos theta, because cos theta is the multiplicative inverse of sec theta, that is cos theta is 1 upon root 5.
So here we will write, since the cos theta is equal to 1 upon sec theta, put the values there. So we have cos theta is equal to 1 upon value of sec theta, that is root 5. So this is the value of cos theta. Now you can easily get the value of sin theta, since we have to get all the remaining trigonometric ratios. We have given tan, we get sec theta, then we get cos theta. Now you can get sin theta also, easily we can get sin theta. We have two identities here. You can write tan theta is equal to sin theta upon cos theta also, or you can use sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. You can use any identity. You can use any identity. Suppose you write here is tan theta is equal to sin theta upon cos theta. Tan theta is 2, it is equal to sin theta we have to find, and cos theta is 1 upon root 5. Now transfer this 1 upon root 5, which is there in the division. So it will went into multiplication, and you will get sin theta is equal to 2 multiplied by 1 upon root 5, and it is equal to sin theta is equal to 2 upon root 5. 2 upon root 5, that is the value of sin theta. Now we know that cosec theta is the multiplicative inverse of sin theta, so you can write here cosec theta is equal to 1 upon sin theta. Cosec theta is equal to 1 upon sin theta. We have cosec theta is equal to 1 upon 2 upon root 5. So here you can write this one as it is, multiplied by multiplicative inverse of 2 upon root 5, that is root 5 upon 2, and we have cosec theta is equal to root 5 upon 2. Now just one trigonometric ratio is remaining. We find sin theta, we get cos theta, we get sec theta, we get cosec theta. Only one ratio is remaining, that is cot theta. And here you can write cot theta is equal to 1 upon tan theta. Cot theta is equal to 1 upon tan theta. Put the values there. Cot theta is equal to value of 1 upon tan theta, that is 2. So we have cot theta is equal to 1 upon 2. So this is all about the third question. It is too easy. But we have two different methods here. You can use triangle method, which we studied in the 9th standard, or you can use the trigonometric identities. It is very easy to use the trigonometric identities. We'll get the practice of trigonometric identities. And see, we get all the values, all the 6 trigonometric ratios. 1 is given here, and we get the 5 values. This is 1, this is 2, 3, 4 and 5 values we get there. 5 remaining trigonometric ratios we find. So here this question is gets completed. We will take next question, that is question number 4. Question number 4 from the problem set 6. The question is, if sec theta is equal to 13 upon 12, if sec theta is equal to 13 upon 12, then find the other trigonometric ratios. Other means we have to find each and every trigonometric ratio. There are 6 trigonometric ratios in all, and we have given the value of sec theta, that is sec theta is equal to 13 upon 12, that is the given information. And now we have to find the remaining 5 trigonometric ratios, that is sin, cos, tan, cot and cosec. So as we know that if sec theta is equal to 13 by 12, then definitely cos theta is equal to 12 upon 13. Since the cos theta is the multiplicative inverse of the sec theta, we can easily get the value of cos theta. So here we will write cos theta is equal to 1 upon sec theta. Now put the values there. So cos theta is equal to 1 upon 13 upon 12, 1 upon 13 upon 12, and we have cos theta is equal to, this one remains as it is, and multiplicative inverse of 13 upon 12, that is 12 upon 13. So we have cos theta is equal to 12 upon 13. Now you can easily get the value of sine theta, because sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So here we will write sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Put the values there. We have to find the sine theta, so sine square theta remains as it is. We know the cos theta, it is 12 upon 13, square of it, that is equal to 1. So here we have sine square theta is equal to sine square theta plus 144 upon 169, that is equals to 1. Now transfer this term 144 upon 169 to the right side. We will get the value of sine square theta, that is sine square theta is equals to 1 minus 144 upon 169. Now here we have to take the subtraction. This is multiplication of denominator to the denominator, it is 169. Cross multiplication is to the numerator, that is 169 minus 144, and the subtraction is 25 upon 169. Taking square root of both the sides, we will get sine theta is equal to 5 by 13. Now you can easily get the value of cosec theta, because cosec theta is the multiplicative inverse of sine theta. If sine theta is 5 upon 13, then cosec theta is 13 upon 5, that is multiplicative inverse of reciprocal of sine theta. So here you can write cosec theta is equal to 1 upon sine theta. Put the values there. Cosec theta is equal to 1 upon 5 upon 13, and that is cosec theta is equal to 13 upon 5. Since we have to find all trigonometric ratios, we have given one value sec theta, and we have to find the other 5 values. We get 1, 2 and 3 values. Now 2 more values remaining, tan theta and cot theta. So here we will find first tan theta. Since we have identity, tan theta is equals to, we have an identity, tan theta is equals to sin theta upon cos theta. Put the values there. The value of sin theta is 5 upon 13 divided by, the value of cos theta is, the value of cos theta is 12 by 13, is 13 gets cancelled, and we have, this is 5 upon 13 multiplied by multiplicative inverse of 12 upon 13, that is 13 upon 12, here 13 gets cancelled, and we have 5 upon 12, that is the value of tan theta. And as we know that cot theta is the multiplicative inverse of tan theta, you can write this is cot theta is equal to 1 upon tan theta. Put the values there. This cot theta is equal to, cot theta is equal to 1 upon, value of tan theta is 5 upon 12. Now here we have to put 1 as it is, multiplied by, in place of division we write multiplication, multiplicative inverse of 5 upon 12, that is 12 upon 5. So we have cot theta is equal to 12 upon 5. So here we will get all the 5 trigonometric ratios. We have given the value of sec theta, and we find all the remaining trigonometric ratios. So here we will completed the question number 4. Remaining questions we will take in the next video.